Ever wondered what Langerhans cell histiocytosis is? This intriguing term refers to a medical condition characterized by the abnormal proliferation of Langerhans cells. These cells, which normally play a crucial role in our body's immune response, start to multiply excessively in this disorder, potentially migrating from the skin to the lymph nodes. Langerhans cell histiocytosis, or LCH, is part of a larger group of conditions known as histiocytoses, which are characterized by an abnormal increase in the number of histiocytes. Histiocytes are a type of cell that are part of our immune system, and their overproduction can lead to various health issues. LCH can present in several ways, ranging from isolated bone lesions to a multisystem disease affecting multiple organs. It's a condition that can truly affect almost any part of the body, making it a complex and fascinating topic to explore. So, if you're curious about the world of medical science or simply want to understand more about this unique condition, you're in the right place. Stay tuned as we delve deeper into this intriguing medical condition. What causes Langerhans cell histiocytosis, and how common is it? This is a question that has intrigued medical professionals and researchers for years. Langerhans cell histiocytosis, or LCH, is a complex disease, and its exact cause is still a topic of ongoing debate. Some argue that it's the result of a reactive process, an overreaction of the immune system, if you will. Others suggest it's a neoplastic process, essentially a form of cancer. But what is clear is that LCH is characterized by the abnormal proliferation of Langerhans cells, a type of immune cell that normally helps the body fight off infections. A significant breakthrough came when researchers identified a somatic mutation in the BRF gene in LCH biopsy samples. Now, somatic mutations are changes in DNA that occur after conception, which means they aren't inherited or passed on to offspring. This particular mutation in the BRF gene leads to an overactive BRAF protein, which in turn promotes the growth and proliferation of cells, in this case, the Langerhans cells. Now, let's talk about the prevalence of LCH. As it turns out, this disease is quite rare. It's estimated that LCH affects about 1 in 200,000 children each year. It can occur at any age, but it's more common in children aged 1 to 3 years. That said, there's also a unique form of LCH called pulmonary LCH that occurs almost exclusively in adult smokers. So to sum it up, while the exact cause of LCH remains elusive, the discovery of the BRAF gene mutation has shone a light on the path towards understanding this complex disease. It's a stepping stone, a clue that brings us closer to unraveling the mysteries of LCH. Although the cause remains a topic of debate, the genetic link is a significant step towards understanding LCH. How would you know if you or someone else might be suffering from LCH? Well, it's not always straightforward, as this condition can cause a range of symptoms, many of which can be quite nonspecific. For instance, a person with LCH might experience fever and weight loss. These are general symptoms that can be associated with a variety of health conditions, not just LCH. This is why LCH can sometimes be difficult to diagnose based solely on symptoms. Now, moving on to the organ-specific symptoms. These can vary widely depending on which organs are involved. LCH can affect almost any organ in the body, so the symptoms can be quite diverse. Let's delve a bit deeper and look at the three clinical groups of the disease, namely unifocal, multifocal, unisystem, and multifocal, multisystem. Unifocal LCH, as the name suggests, involves the proliferation of Langerhans cells in just one organ, so the symptoms will be related to that specific organ. Multifocal unisystem LCH is a bit more complex. It's characterized by fever, bone lesions, and diffuse eruptions. So in addition to fever and weight loss, a person with this type of LCH might experience pain or tenderness in the affected bones and skin rashes. Lastly, we have multifocal multisystem LCH, also known as Langerhans-Cell disease. This is a rapidly progressing disease that affects multiple tissues. The symptoms can be quite severe and widespread as multiple organs are involved. It's important to remember that these are just general guidelines. The exact symptoms can vary from person to person, and some people might not experience any symptoms at all in the early stages of the disease. Recognizing these symptoms can lead to early detection and better management of the condition. It's always a good idea to seek medical advice if you're experiencing symptoms that worry you or are causing discomfort. Remember, early detection is key in managing any health condition effectively. How do doctors confirm the presence of LCH? Well, the answer lies in a two-step process that involves imaging and histological examination of tissue biopsy. Let's start with imaging. It plays a vital role in assessing the extent of the disease. Various imaging tools such as X-rays, Connecticut scans, and MRI can be used to look for signs of LCH in different organs. This helps in understanding whether the disease is isolated to one organ or has spread to multiple systems. However, imaging alone is not enough. To confirm the diagnosis, doctors rely on something called a histological examination. This involves taking a small sample of tissue, known as a biopsy, from the affected organ and examining it under a microscope. What they are looking for are abnormal Langerhans cells, the hallmark of LCH. It's worth noting that this process is not a simple tick box exercise. It requires highly skilled health professionals, advanced equipment, and careful interpretation of results. But it's an essential step in the journey towards treatment because, as we all know, proper diagnosis is key to effective treatment. What happens after a diagnosis of LCH, you might be wondering? Well, the journey to recovery begins with understanding the treatment options available. The course of treatment for Langerhans cell histiocytosis depends largely on how far the disease has progressed and the organs it has affected. The good news is we have a range of effective treatments at our disposal. One of the treatment options is excision. This involves the surgical removal of the lesion. Excision is typically considered when the disease is limited to a single area, such as a bone lesion, making it easier to remove the abnormal cells completely. If the disease is widespread, radiation therapy might be recommended. This treatment uses high energy rays to kill the abnormal cells and prevent them from growing and spreading. It's a powerful tool in the fight against LCH, especially when the disease has spread to hard-to-reach areas. Then there's chemotherapy, a treatment option that uses drugs to stop the growth of the abnormal cells. Chemotherapy can be systemic, meaning it affects the entire body, or localized, where it's directed at a specific area. This treatment is often used when LCH has affected multiple organs or systems. It's important to remember that the choice of treatment isn't one size fits all. Each patient's situation is unique, and the treatment plan is tailored to their specific needs. The medical team will take into account factors like the patient's age, overall health, and the extent and severity of the disease. The journey through LCH treatment might seem daunting, but it's important not to lose hope. With the right treatment approach, many patients see significant improvement, and in some cases, complete remission is achieved. Remember, you're not alone in this fight. There's a whole team of doctors, nurses, and specialists ready to help you navigate this journey every step of the way. Though challenging, LCH can be managed with the right treatment approach. So what have we learned about Langerhans cell histiocytosis? We've journeyed together through the complex world of this disease, understanding its nature and how it manifests. We've discussed that LCH is an unusual disorder characterized by the abnormal proliferation of certain immune cells, notably Langerhans cells, which can affect nearly any organ in the body. We've delved into the etiology and epidemiology of LCH, highlighting the debates surrounding its pathogenesis and the role of the BRAF gene mutation. We've illuminated the varied clinical symptoms from non-specific signs like fever and weight loss to organ-specific manifestations. We've also explored the crucial role of radiological evaluations and histological examinations in diagnosing this disease. And finally, we've touched on the different treatment options available, guided by the extent of the disease, which can range from surgical excision and radiation to chemotherapy. Langerhans cell. Histiocytosis is indeed a complex and multifaceted disease, but understanding it is a stepping stone towards better management. And hopefully, with continued research and advancements, we can look forward to a future where a cure is within reach. Understanding LCH is a step towards better management and hopefully in the future, a cure. For more detailed information on Langerhans cell histiocytosis, you might find the following resources helpful. A comprehensive overview is available on the Wikipedia page titled Langerhans cell histiocytosis. Here you'll find an in-depth look at the disease, its history, and its various names through the decades. For those who seek a more scientific understanding, consider diving into scholarly articles and medical journals. Websites such as PubMed or Google Scholar are treasure troves of information filled with studies and research papers on the topic. If you or a loved one are directly affected by LCH, Patient-focused resources like the Histiocytosis Association offer support, education, and community. They provide valuable insights, not just on the medical aspects, but also on living with the condition. Remember, knowledge is power. The more we understand about conditions like Langerhans cell histiocytosis, the better equipped we are to manage them, find better treatments, and hopefully one day, a cure. Until next time, stay curious, stay informed, and stay healthy.